ओम नमः शिवाय स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद क्लास 11 पॉलिटिकल साइंस चैप्टर 4 पार्ट 2 द एग्जीक्यूटिव। इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैड एन इंट्रोडक्शन टू द चैप्टर एंड लर्नड अबाउट व्हाट इज एन एग्जीक्यूटिव। इन दिस सेशन वी विल हैव अ डिस्कशन अबाउट टाइप्स ऑफ एग्जीक्यूटिव, सेमी प्रेसिडेंशियल एग्जीक्यूटिव इन श्रीलंका। This will be followed with the assignment related to the topic chapter 4 part 2. Now, what are the different types of executive? In this part of the chapter, we will be learning about three different types of executive. That is parliamentary, semi-presidential system and presidential system. Now, every country may not have the same type of executive. You may have heard about the President of USA and the Queen of England. But the powers and functions of the President of USA are very different from the powers of the President of India. How is this so happens? Similarly, the powers of the Queen of England are different from the powers of the King of England, King of Nepal. Both India and France have prime ministers, but their roles are different from each other. Why is this so? In order to answer all these questions, we have to look into three different types of executives that exist in any democracies of the world. Before we move on to the topic, let us focus on to the activity prescribed here in your book. Procure a photograph of the SAARC. The full form of SAARC is South Asian Association of Regional Cooperation. Procure a photograph of the SAARC summit meeting or the meeting of G8 countries. G8 countries are the 8 most powerful countries of the world. Now, who attended the meeting? Now, in the South Asian Association of the Regional Cooperation SAARC summit, the member countries are Nepal, Bhutan, Sri Lanka, Maldives, Pakistan, Bangladesh, India, Afghanistan. These are the member countries that hold meeting at regular intervals. The meeting of the SAARC summit takes place at the interval of 18 months. Now, if we talk about the meeting of the G8 countries, the most powerful 8 countries of the world that are members to it are US, Italy, Russia, Japan, Canada, Germany, France, UK. Now, because of the removal of Russia, it is now on called the G7 country. The meeting of the G8 countries takes place every year. Once in every year, it is compulsory. Now, the question that we are confronted with is, can you imagine why those people and not some others attending the meeting? The answer to this is, because the members of the countries, the members of the summit that exists in it is like the group that have some common ideology that they follow. So they only meet in the meeting and follow the agenda that is discussed in the meeting. Not others are attending the meeting. The like-minded people and the one who takes into consideration the ideologies of the group only meat. Now let us answer about what we have read about the different types of executive. To answer the question, we will briefly outline the nature of the executive existing in some of these countries. The USA has a presidential system, and executive powers are in the hands of the president. Canada has a parliamentary democracy with a constitutional monarchy, where Queen Elizabeth II is the formal chief of the state, and the prime minister is the head of the government. Now in France, both the president and the prime minister are a part of the semi-presidential system. The president appoints the prime minister as well as ministers, but cannot dismiss them as they are responsible to the parliament. So this is called semi-presidential system. Now Japan has a parliamentary system with the emperor as the head of the state and prime minister as the head of the government. Italy, if we talk about, has a parliamentary system with the president as the formal head of the state and the prime minister as the head of the government. Now when we are reading about the countries and talking about the presidential, parliamentary as well as semi-presidential form of government, we are talking about the powers and positions of the president and the prime minister on the one hand, as well as the king, queen and their position in the parliamentary system of government. Now let us talk about Russia as well. Russia has a semi-presidential system where president is the head of the state. That means the treaties are signed in the names of the important treaties are signed in the name of the president. And prime minister, who is appointed by the president, is the head of the government. That means the real executive head who controls the administration of the state or the country is the prime minister. Now Germany has a parliamentary system in which president is the ceremonial head of the state and the chancellor is the head of the government. So here we are talking about the executive and the different roles of the executive in different types of government. Now let us brief this into now, in a presidential system, the president is the head of the state as well as the head of the government. That means the president is having the real power to enjoy in the presidential form of government. In this system, the office of the president is very powerful, both in theory as well as in practice. Countries with such a system include the United States, Brazil, and most nations in Latin America. Now let us sum up the types of executive and their functions. Here is the flowchart representation of the same. Now let us talk about the system based on the principle of collective leadership and system based on the individual leadership. So the types of executive that we are talking about in the collective leadership is the parliamentary form of government and the semi-presidential form of government. Now in the parliamentary form of the government, these are the features of the parliamentary form of government. The head of the government is usually known as the prime minister. So the important post is enjoyed by the prime minister. Prime minister takes all the important decisions related to the administration of the country where the parliamentary form of government is in practice. Now, he is the leader of the majority party in the legislature. Prime Minister is the leader of the majority party in the legislature. That means he is accountable to the legislature. That means answerable to the legislature for his or her working. The head of the state may be the monarch or president. Monarch, if the monarch is the head of the state, his position will be constitutional monarchy, ceremonial executive. And if it is the president is in the parliamentary republic and his position is also ceremonial. That means the powers are enjoyed only in name. His position are subject to the parliament. In the constitutional monarchy or in the parliamentary system of government, in the parliamentary republic, the power and position of the monarch or the president is ceremonial. This means subject to the constitution or subject to the parliament. This is about the parliamentary form of government. So, in the parliamentary form of the government, who is the head of the government? Prime Minister. He is the leader of the majority party and he is answerable for his working to the legislature and enjoys his office as long as the consent of the people in the legislature is in favor of the leader. And in the parliamentary system of government, the head of the state can be either monarch or the president. And both the monarch and the president's position is ceremonial, is only in name. He is only having the signatory authority. Now, if we talk about the presidential system, this is another system based on the principle of collective leadership. Now, in the semi-presidential system, has the president as the head of the state. That means the head of the state is the president. And semi-presidential system has a prime minister as the head of the government. So, real power is enjoyed by the prime minister. And prime minister and his council of minister are responsible to the legislature. So, it is somewhat similar to the parliamentary system of government. In both parliamentary system of government and in the semi-presidential system, prime minister is the real head of the executive, real executive head of the government. Most of the power is enjoyed in the name of the prime minister. President in both the cases is the ceremonial head, is the head of the state. And in both, the prime minister is answerable to the legislature for his or her working. Now, let us go to the another type of executive and understand this, which is based on the system of individual leadership. In the presidential form of government, in contrary to the parliamentary and semi-presidential system, in the presidential form of government, president is the head of the state. He is also the head of the government. That means the real head of the government and the nominal head of the government both is enjoyed by the president. The president is usually directly elected by the people, which is not happening in the parliamentary or semi-presidential system of government. The president is indirectly elected in these two. And in the presidential form of government, the president is usually directly elected by the people and he is not at all accountable or answerable to the legislature for its working. So, these are the three types of executive that we have learnt in this chapter: parliamentary, semi-presidential and presidential. So, now is this clear that why the presidents and prime ministers' post and position differs from country to country. This is because of the acceptance of the parliamentary semi-presidential or the presidential form of government. So in the parliamentary system, if we talk about in the prime minister is the head of the government. Most parliamentary systems have a president or a monarch who is the nominal head of the state. In such a system, the role of the president or monarch is primarily ceremonial, and prime minister along with the cabinet wields effective power. That means the prime minister is more powerful than the president, and the decision making power rests with the prime minister more for the administration of the country. Now, countries with such system include Germany, Italy, Japan, United Kingdom, as well as Portugal. A semi-presidential system has both a president and a prime minister. But unlike the parliamentary system, the president may possess significant day-to-day powers. So this is the genuine difference between the parliamentary and semi-presidential system, that president, unlikely to the parliamentary system, in the semi-presidential system possesses some day-to-day powers in the hand. In the system, it is possible that sometimes the president and the prime minister may belong to the same party, and at times they may belong to two different parties and thus would be opposed to each other. Countries with such a system include France, Russia, Sri Lanka. So this is about the three forms of executive. Now let us read about the semi-presidential executive in Sri Lanka. In 1978, the Constitution of Sri Lanka was amended. Amended means changed. Change in the provision of the constitution. And the system of executive presidency was introduced. Under the system of executive presidency, people directly elect the president. It may happen that both the president and prime minister belong to the same political party or to the different political parties. The president has vast powers under the constitution. The president chooses the prime minister from the party that has a majority in the parliament. Though ministers must be members of the parliament, that means either the prime minister can be the member of the parliament, or soon after his appointment he has to join the membership of the parliament. The president has the power to remove the prime minister or ministers apart from being the elected head of the state and commander in chief of the armed forces. That means the president has the power to remove the prime minister in the semi-presidential system, as well as the president in the semi-presidential system is the head of the chief of the armed forces and also the head of the state and the commander-in-chief of the armed forces. The president is also the head of the government. Now, elected for a term of 6 years, the president cannot be removed except by the resolution in the parliament. Resolution in the parliament means change brought in the parliament, passed by at least 2/3 of the total number of members of the parliament. If it is passed by not less than 1/2 of the total number of members of the parliament, and the speaker is satisfied that such allegations merit inquiry, then the speaker can report the matter to the Supreme Court. Now, how is the position of the president and prime minister in Sri Lanka different from India? Compare the role of Supreme Court in the impeachment of president in India and Sri Lanka. Now, what we have learnt over here is that the president of Sri Lanka can be removed by the parliament, whereas in the in India, the president can be removed by the process of impeachment only, which is decided by the Supreme Court in India. In Sri Lanka, the process of impeachment which is not followed. In Sri Lanka, unlike India, the president can be directly removed by the system of votes when at least 2/3 of the total numbers of the members of the parliament shows the no confidence motion or passes the no confidence motion against the president. So parliament can remove the president in Sri Lanka, not in India. Now the assignment that has to be followed in chapter 4 part 2 are as: number 1, what are the different types of executive? In this you have to write about the three different types of executive that you have learnt and the feature of each. Now second one is differentiate between the parliamentary and presidential form of government. In regard to the features of the parliamentary and presidential form of government, you will write the differences. In the next session, chapter 4 part 3, we will be doing the parliamentary executive in India. Om Namah Shivaya.